Right now we're driving to Kelvin and Clifton's house. We arranged for a little tribute. My uncle, Myles Coker, died from the coronavirus, and that's Kelvin Clifton's father. Myles Coker was probably the most in-shape man that I've ever known. I used to go to New York every summer for a few weeks and work out with him, run around the park, do some pull-ups on the playground, push-ups and sit-ups in the morning. And some of the stuff that we did together is stuff that I do now on my own. He's still coaching me from above, so we're gonna play his favorite song. We got me and a bunch of friends that are coming over there right now. We're gonna be parked around the corner from Kelvin and Clifton's house, and then we're gonna call them outside. And when they come outside, they're gonna see a whole bunch of friends and family to tribute and honor their father. So, see you in a bit. So we're legitimately parked right down the block from Kelvin and Clifton's crib. That's him in the distance. This bro has no clue what's about to happen. It's so crazy, like there's literally so many people here right now for this celebration. It's gonna be awesome. Yeah. They're the ones who organized it right there. They're the ones that organized it.
We're about to do a surprise drive-by for the Cokers, Kelvin, Cliff, and the entire Lynch family to show our love and support for their dad, Myles, who passed away from COVID.
Who we love so, so much.
So they're going first, then it's gonna be me and the fam, and then all friends. I'm not sure if we're gonna stop in front of the house. I'm sure we are, but either way, we're gonna play that whole song. Okay. We're about to get the signal to have all the cars drive forward. Here come the balloons. And it begins.
Second thing is that we just want to tell you the meaning behind that song. So, it was our dad's favorite song. And before he died, you know, we couldn't be there. And they were able to put us on a Zoom call. And he had been in a induced coma for like a week. And they put us on the camera and we were able to speak with him for like 30 minutes. And we played that song and we told him, you know, things, and that's the meaning behind that song. So thank you guys.
We love y'all. We love you, man.
I've never cried in front of people like you before. It's the first for me. And like you said, that song is very special. When we picked him up from prison, that's the song. That's the song you played.
We love this song, man.
That's the song we played all the time for him. He wanted that to be played after he got out of prison, and it's, you know, it had a variety of meanings behind it.
He was in jail for 23 years.
Yep.
And he had been home with us for like six years.
Yeah, and now.
That this is very, very special. You guys are incredible. We thank you so much for this. This is crazy.
Debbie, Aunt Debbie. We love Tippy too. Where's Tippy?
You know, continue to be safe and like, you know, just whatever. Everybody be safe. I can't wait till like we can all hug and like and hang out again. And like, this is unbelievable. Like, it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous.
I need that song on repeat.
All right, I got you.
I need that song on repeat.
Now the heart you hold is somebody else, baby. Yeah.
Yes, Tippy! Tippy! Yo, amazing. Thank you. Yo, you're the best. Love Myles, man. Love him.